fellow Portland Trailblazer fans. I know this sucks to say and reality hurts, but this 2019 injury-laden season and having half a new roster with the same old coaching and management formula that's been there for like 6-7 years isn't working anymore. It's over. We're almost halfway through. It's 2020 now. The season is nearing the halfway point. The Trailblazers are sucking. Sure, they got some guys that are great for ISO ball. That's the problem. They play ISO ball all the time. And yeah, there's tons of injuries. And there's literally only two guys playing left from that Western Conference team from last season, Damian Lillard and CJ McCollum. And that's it, except Anthony Simons, who hardly played anything. And Anthony Simons is turning into an ISO ball player first, too. Dribble, 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 shoot. The pass is secondary to him. This formula, I see there's always people, when I say this on social media, YouTube or Instagram, you get all these people commenting, no, we still got hope. We'll just got to make it to the playoffs. Make it to the playoffs? That's not enough. We've made it to the playoffs for like the last seven seasons. Where our goal was Western Conference Finals and beyond the finals. That's what you're looking for. And then I get all these people on, when I make this comment that we need to, it's time, I hate to say this because I know the players like it, but it's time to fire Stotts because he's not changing his ISO ball formula, his play formula. He's not emphasizing hustle, get back on defense, move, pass the ball. You know, he's not emphasizing that. He's the ISO ball coach, you know. James Harden would be his wet dream. And ISO ball's great. You know, you got Lillard and CJ. And when those guys are on, it's great. They're going to win a few games. It's going to look amazing. But that's not a long-term formula for success. That's a formula for long-term failure. The Warriors, the legendary Warriors, even though they had amazing ISO ball players and that could do that, their defense was one of the best in the leagues. And their passing and their assists were amazing. That's what made them so good. It wasn't just they had ISO ball players. Look at Houston. They haven't made it to the – when was the last Western Conference Finals they were in? Maybe it was last year or the year before. I don't know. But, you know, they're getting more pieces too. But that's how Portland's playing. And they need to get rid of – they need to get a new coach. They need to emphasize this defense because defense sucks in Portland. Teams are just laying the ball up in the paint left and right, alley-ooping in the paint. There's nothing. And, yeah, all their bigs are injured and down, most of them. The team has new guys, but still, the effort isn't even there. The communication, because all the new players haven't gelled together yet. But what bugs me on the social media sites is how people can't just face reality. The run of that Trailblazers team is over. It's not the same team. And then people have this fantasy, oh, when Nurk comes back, Nurkic won't be good for another full season under his belt minimum. Just like Paul George and Gordon Hayward had the same injuries. It took those guys a whole season and a half even, to get back to their former selves. And Zach Collins, same thing. They aren't saying how bad his shoulder injury is, but obviously he's coming back towards the end of the season and he's going to be like not in a good state either. People need to face reality. The owner needs to get Neil Olshey out of there, the manager, who does these huge gamble trades every 3 years or whatever, cripples the Trailblazers financially, so they can't do anything anyways unless they want to trade away their ultra stars, CJ or Damian, you know. And Stotts just doesn't want to. He doesn't want to change his technique. He doesn't emphasize defense. He doesn't get the team moving fast. You know, it's just like people can fantasize all they want, and you're not being a disloyal fan just because you realize, oh yeah, this system isn't working anymore. It's like how. What Chuck and not Ernie, but Kenny say on, what is it, NBA TNT with Shaq and all that. They're always talking about, yeah, that team's done. You know, I didn't want to admit it, but now I can see it. It's true, man. And it's cool having Melo on there. You know, he brings a spark. But we just need more. And we don't have time or money. So that's the reality. The Trailblazers suck this season after having a great last season. They don't have it, man. This ISO ball, same old formula is not going to work. And by the way, when people respond to you, to comments on social media, YouTube or Instagram, or I don't do Facebook anymore personally because it annoys me, have the balls to at least not be hiding behind a private account or have no videos or anything posted, because that's just a troll. Nobody respects trolls and what you have to say. So if you want to talk and blast your opinion off and trolling other people's comments all the time at least have a face that's real and not hidden behind a fake or private account. Let's get some fucking balls in life. And our balls in life as Trailblazers fan right now is to admit our team sucks. We're screwed. There's great players on there and things could be done, but we need some major tweaks. And I think those tweaks have to start from the top, management and coaching. We need to, and I don't know who's available. I don't have any suggestions for that. Tom Thibodeau maybe? How about Mark Jackson? He's the one who built the wires up, coaching them to the great point. And then Steve Kerr just stepped into that position and took over when they were already good. I don't know, something like that. Something needs to change. And people are fantasizing that it's not. And then people have this stupid thing. Yeah, look, we're just going to make the play. Some guy was giving me a bunch of crap, this kid on Instagram. I think he's a kid, the way he talks. I can't tell. Saying, yeah, we just need to make it to the playoffs, and then it's a whole new season. No, that's not a whole new season. It's the playoffs. You're facing the top of the top. You're going to get your ass kicked if you barely made it in there, unless you got incredibly lucky. And I mean incredibly. I remember when I was a kid, the year the Trailblazers won the championship, 77, I was a little kid. They were like a good team, but they weren't great, but they did have a surprise run in the playoffs to make it to the finals and win. But they were way better than the Blazers are now. It wasn't like that type of comparison. So, yeah, I don't even think the Blazers will make the playoffs, honestly. Of course, I could be proven wrong here if Neil Olshey, who's a big gambler on trades, does something before the deadline here at the end of the month. When is that? It's January 3rd right now. So if he does something in the next couple weeks, I mean, I don't know what he could do to really make it that much more significant. And I don't know that Paul Allen's sister, after he died, she got the team and the Seahawks. I don't know if she just buys into the whole Neil Olshey car salesman. He's a big talker. He likes to talk it up, and he's like a used car salesman, a glorified used car salesman. But I mean, the Trailblazers suck this year. It's just even hard to watch. It's bad when you see a team like when I watched the Phoenix game the other night, and they were up 20 at the end of the first quarter. I was like, oh, they're going to lose this game. And they did this last season, too, a lot, frequently. I saw it like 7 or 8, maybe up to 10 times that I can recall. They'd get like huge leads at the start of the game, and then they'd just relax. They'd hit some sweet shots and kind of gloat about their shots and kind of trot back slowly to the other side. And teams are just out-hustling them, running right by them and doing layups and like passing the ball right down the court because there's no hustle. And there's some guys like Kent Bazemore I like a lot because of his hustle play. The guys that hustle. Hassan Whiteside is doing better than people thought he would. He's making free throws. And I don't know, the system's just messed up, though. CJ's a bit of a ball hog. He looks sweet when he's on. Damian's got his assist up a little bit, I think, from last year. It seems like he gets more assists sometimes. It's just not a system that's going to work, man. They need something else there, and that's just how it is, Trailblazer fan. The Blazers suck this season so far, halfway through. They probably will, because that's... If it projects how it has been, they won't make the playoffs. If you multiply what they have by 2 now, it's not a playoff team. You know, whatever. It just sucks, but that's how it is. Face reality.